Hello everybody and welcome back to Ships at War. I've created two ship annihilators, but they might not be what you're expecting. This is the ship destroyer. It is a crazy battleship with 28 inch guns, but I'm gonna show you what this thing does in a battle. I'm gonna put it up against the Bismarck. Okay, so I am just gonna get us moving right out and have all of our guns start firing. Once the guns reach him, oh boy, let's watch this. So this thing has just 8-inch guns, which are kind of small in comparison to what these guys have, 16-inch guns and 10-inch guns, but there are so many shells hitting this ship. So he dies. There's no way he survives this. This is like 20 seconds into the battle and we're already magazining him. Look at, he's already splitting in half. Look at our ship. We do have way too many magazines. Oh, you just experienced the magazine hit. So if they do get a lucky shot, they might blow up our whole ship if they trigger multiple magazines. But I'm pretty sure that they're gonna go down before us. It's actually just raining shells. Ooh, dang. That was, remember, that's 3 times our power. The Bismarck was 1200 fleet power and we were 500. So it really comes to show how overpowered this thing is. So let's take this thing again and put it up against an aircraft carrier. Last episode, we realized aircraft carriers are very, very, very overpowered. And so I'm going to be fighting against one with this. It's actually 3 times our power. It's 500 against 1500. But I'm pretty confident we're just going to destroy this thing quick and easy. All our guns are rounding out. Oh, look at that. Oh, they're all firing in unison. Oh, I got them to all fire in unison. Oh, how beautiful. Look at, some of these ships are smoking because we're getting direct hits on them while they're on their deck. 8 ships smoking. So they drop their torpedoes at us, but I'm not scared of the torpedo bombers. Oh, they are going a little bit weird and funky. Oh, I don't know why they're going above the water. That might do some more damage. Okay, we're still good. What? How did that break? What? How did that one shot us? I put armor there. Apparently, it doesn't think I did. That doesn't matter though, because look at this ship. Oh my gosh. It looks so hacked and mangled. Oh my gosh. It looks like someone just took a chainsaw to it. I think that might be a little bit overkill. Ah, okay. We won the battle. Okay, so we just did fight with this thing, but I have not fought against it. I'm not going to try to bring a battleship against this thing because I don't think I have a chance. I think my best chance is with an aircraft carrier. So I'm going to take the Juno. I think that I will be able to do some more damage than it did to us. Oh my gosh. Oh, they're all firing in unison. Ooh, doesn't look so good for us. Oh, we get to see what it feels like. Oh my gosh. Look, our Zero is flaming. It's going up in smoke. That one is going up in smoke. They're all getting hit on the deck by these 8mm rounds and they start to smoke. Dude, they just sniped one of our planes. That's insane. Let's see, have we gotten close to it? Oh, our dive bombers are all dropping in front because he stopped moving. Oh, come on. He stopped moving forward. Oh, but hopefully our glitch torpedoes can maybe penetrate up here. I see a bit of a magazine. Ooh, I'm pretty sure I saw a magazine there. Ooh, wow. I didn't realize. I don't think I armored up the front of the ship enough. I think I armored up here, but I don't think I remember armoring down here. Oh, I don't know if that's gonna matter. We will be sunken in 22 seconds. This is insane. Okay, yeah, we sunk and we died. So unless I had perfect aim with my dive bombers, which is hard because I don't know where the AI is gonna stop. And because the ship moves pretty fast, I just have no idea where it's gonna be. So unless I knew exactly where it's gonna be, I don't think I could really stop that. I did make 2 ships, if you do remember at the beginning of the video. So the first one I showed you was the super battleship, but this one is kind of the opposite scale. This one's a tiny little PT boat. He's got 6 torpedo launchers and 8 4-meter propellers. This thing does look tiny, like it is tiny. It's absolutely minuscule, but it does destroy. So let's take this PT boat, 510 fleet power, up against the USS Yamato. I can't even say it wrong. I can't force myself to say it wrong. The Imperial Japanese Yamato. The Yamato. I'm saying it right, but I don't feel like I'm saying it right. Yamato. The Imperial Japanese Navy Yamato. Yes, the Imperial Japanese Navy Yamato. I thought I was saying it weirdly. Yamato. Yamato. But I'm fairly certain that we can destroy this. The Yamato is the one that's really hard to beat with my boat here. I don't know why I picked it, because it has a little belt here that's all armored up. So it's like a torpedo belt. Like in real life, they had these. So whenever I hit the here, I won't do any real damage to their main ship. When the other ships, they don't have this. So it's kind of a little dumb of me. But we're going so fast that the... Okay, well, the torpedo bombers know where we are because they dropped ahead. But we went so fast, the torpedo bomb was like dropped right here. Then they're supposed to drop like here because we're moving so fast. And we're fine because I am an amazing ship engineer and I've designed it so it does not break to a few hits of a torpedo. I don't know how this will affect it. We might hit above the torpedo belt. If we get close enough, we might be hitting up here. And we might flood them from up the above that torpedo belt. Let's see. Okay, we're not in range just yet. I think we are now. It looks so funny. There are little glitches in this game because it is in development. But bug fixes are coming out quite often, which is great for the game. He's already flooding in here. I think that's the design of the ship's mistake, I think. Let's watch them all impact, all three in a row. Let's see. Oh, whoa, we did some damage. That triple collision, that did some damage.
Oh, that's a lot of damage.
Because of the so much damage, we just did that. I'm going to try that again. I'm going to fire all of these rounds together and sing and hope that happens again. I have not seen that before. So hopefully, like, all of these rounds together. But, oh, they collided. That's the other thing. You don't want to fire them two in sync, or else they collide. Oh, wow, he's going down hard. Let's do all of the torpedoes again. Let's see if we can try to do the same thing. I think it's too late now to actually do any real damage. I think they collided again, because we only have four coming out. The upper ones may have collided. And it doesn't really matter, because they are also hacked and mangled, and they are going down. Look at that. Ouch. How are you firing? Okay, the rear gun literally tips up, pointed upside down, and it fires at us. Okay, so now let's take this PT boat up against an aircraft carrier and see what it can do. I'm gonna take it up against the Juno aircraft carrier. Okay, let's move it. So we have to make sure that we move quite, like, even right when we spawn, because we do not want any of those torpedoes hitting us. They probably will, but those dive bombers really do some damage. Ooh, torpedo bombers launched first. How peculiar. I assume they're gonna drop, like, right dead in front of us, like, actually right here. I've got a defense mechanism also. When they do drop, I can try to intercept them with torpedoes. Nope, didn't work there. Did it. See? Ooh, 2 for 2. Well, 2 for 3. Oh, he might drop. Nope. Okay. 2 for 2. That's pretty good, though. Blocking of torpedo hits. It's not bad. Oh, is he gonna drop, like, directly on us? Oh, no, he dropped behind us. Haha, you're trash. How far behind me does he drop? Wow, pretty far behind me. We are hitting them above the water line, though. I'm not sure if that's bad or if that's good. Oh, ooh. Oh, wow, direct hit on the plane. I hope that they don't pierce the armor. Our armor is pretty strong. I think I did a double layer of armor at the front to stop torpedoes. Ooh, they did pierce the upper part, though. Okay, so the front of their ship is drooping. It's way harder to fight aircraft carriers because for some reason they just love to, like, stay alive. It's quite irritating. I do not like when they try to stay alive so much. What are they doing? They're doing loop-de-loops and they're dropping on their own ship. Because they want to drop in front of us, the closest they can drop is by doing a loop-de-loop and dropping it on their own ship. No way. No way. Dude, that's hilarious. Bro, I'm like having a... Oh, dude! We just collided with one torpedo in mid-air. Oh, they hit us in the worst spot. They broke this armor here. I couldn't waterproof in these two spots, so if we do dunk over on the back end, we start flooding a lot. I do not think that matters, because they sunk. Yes, yes, yes. So my two creations are very overpowered after all. There is one thing I have not done. I have not fought these two ships together. I'm going to be the PT boat, and I'm going to fight Z Ship Destroyer, or the KMS Grav Zeppelin's body with a ton of guns on it. I can't do the other way around because this thing doesn't know how to work with the AI. The AI fires all of the torpedoes simultaneously, because as you can see, this one fires basically all of its shells almost simultaneously, and they all collide and they explode, so it can't actually damage anyone, so I have to be him. But this guy can perfectly well damage me. I am pretty fast, so I can dodge a lot, but I can't dodge everything. One shot, two shots, three shots, four. Oh, wow, that's a hail of fire. Look at how many shots are missing, though, and how many shots are still hitting us. Like, this is a lot of shots hitting my ship. Like, this little ship doesn't have that much armor. Like, that many shells, doing that until, like, over here, I don't know if we're gonna make it. But look at how many are missing. I would say, like, more than 80% are missing completely. Oh, they're breaking us open. Oh, we're flooding because they just broke this part open. I've got a good amount of bilge pumps, so we should... sunk in 6 minutes. Hopefully we're in range. If we do get lucky and we do hit their magazines, we might be able to win the battle. But if we don't... Ooh, top two torpedoes are out. So now we only have 4 guns. If we are not lucky enough, then we probably will die. This looks insane. Wait, why don't I move forward? Oh, I didn't tell my ship to move forward anymore. Wow, that was really dumb. So I've just been taking a hail of fire that I shouldn't have needed to be taking. Oh my gosh, that's so dumb. That was very stupid. I think I might actually go down because I didn't tell my ship to move forward enough. Oh boy. We have just been taking external damage.
External damage.
But he can't take that much external damage. Oh, because look, oh my gosh, come on. Thread the needle, thread the needle, thread the needle. Oh, come on. He hits one magazine. That's cheap. Oh, and he's taking out more of our guns. Oh, I think I know why. Okay. Okay, come on, come on. Come on, you idiots. Why can't the torpedoes just hit the magazines? I almost had him. You shall rue the Daisy super battleship. I made this one first, and I was super proud of it because it could take down almost every ship. And then I thought, what if you put that many guns? And I was like, I don't think it will allow that much fleet power. And I'm like, but a lot of little guns would do it. So I took an aircraft carrier because it gave you a lot of points. And they didn't have two big guns. And I did it, and I got a lot of guns on there. So there is another one that I can try. It's called Marathon, where you fight an increasingly bigger threat or warship each wave. So I'm going to try it first with the PT boat. I don't know how well I'm going to do. I think I did it once before with the PT boat, and I get two waves in or something. But I think I have a pretty good chance. I'm going to keep firing ones until we get pretty close. So let's do that thing where we hit him so many times he doesn't know how to survive. Boom, 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 boom. I'm not even hitting the bottom of his ship. I'm just sniping his guns, which I can't say is too terrible because now he can't fire at me. Besides, oh, actually, he still can. Come on. So basically how this works is once this guy sinks, the next ship will spawn right here. So that means I'll be really close to him, but they will be really close to me. And sometimes the next ship is an aircraft carrier. No, that's three ships in. After we beat the next ship, the one after that's an aircraft carrier, so we've got to be pretty careful. Oh, it's a cruiser, okay. Oh, wow, he's literally right in front of us. Wow, oh, I smoked one, like, right under. He fires depth charges at us, and it actually sucks. And because they hit where they hit impact. Oh, yeah, we're still afloat. We're taking on some water. Oh, we're pumping. Oh, yes, we broke front armor. Oh, we destroyed one gun. Oh, we're sinking. Okay, that's kind of not great. How much damage can we do before we go down? I hope some more. Nope, we lost steam power to one boiler. Once we lose steam power to the other boiler, we're going down. Oh, no. So when I fire, they drop into my own ship, which is so funny but stupid. Oh, he is going down kind of fast, though. So let's see. Can we take down the second wave? Ooh, aircraft carrier is coming up now. We won the second wave. Oh, you fire the first gun. Oh, it fired, literally fired backwards. So we have to fight the illustrious, I think. Yeah. No, it's the Junio. Don't think it really matters, though, because we're going down. It's okay. I think I kind of made a mistake there. I think I got a bit too close. I think I just have to stay right in range of my torpedoes, because the closer they get, the faster the planes come, and then more time I have to maneuver around. I could try to, like, have myself move back and forth, so then dive bombers all miss. I think I technically could beat that third wave with that thing, but I think we have a better chance with the ship destroyer. So now we're going to do the marathon again, but this time with the KMS ship destroyer. Okay, wait, I'm gonna fire a little bit ahead because I don't know how fast it's gonna go. The HMS OP class destroyer. Oh, magazines, critical hits. Oh my gosh, this thing destroys. It's causing lag. How is this thing still floating? You've been hit with like 150 rounds. So the next wave is a cruiser. I think we can take him out pretty quick. We can make quick work of that man. Okay, so he spawns even closer than the last ship did. Let's see how much damage we're doing. He is a larger ship slightly, so we will get more hits on him. It's so much lag though. Okay, aircraft carrier. Wave 3. Coming up. I'm pretty sure that if we try to get our distance from this aircraft carrier, we can do something. I had an idea for this thing. I could make it run away. I could make it reverse and go away from all of the enemies, but I don't know. Maybe I could try that. When their dive bombers do get close, I'm going to have us go rear. Or maybe I'll just do that straight off because we do not want them getting close to us at all. Oh, we're already open fired on him. Okay, we need to start moving now, like this millisecond. We need to start moving 10 seconds ago because once their dive bombers get up in the air and if they drop anywhere near us, like I saw a dive bomber drop like here and we went up, like everything exploded. Any direct hit with a dive bomber, we're done for. We're like just bleh. I can beat an aircraft carrier because it takes a while for their planes to get to me, but in this scenario I don't actually. Bravely running away.
He buggered off. So he has, he's scarpered.
Brave got off and run away.
No!
Bravely ran away.
I didn't.
When danger reared its ugly head, he bravely turned his tail.
No!
And yet brave Sir Robin turned about.
I didn't.
He chickened out.
Lies!
Get away from this place. Dive bombers, no, don't you dare. I hope that the dive bombers thought I was going to be over here because that's how fast I was moving. And I hope that the dive bombers don't like... Oh, the dive bombers are stupid. They are taking quite... Oh, they're starting to flood. I think we hit some damage. Okay. So I flipped us around again because it looked like the dive bombers were going to get direct hits on us. Okay, let's see how are we doing. We're not flooding or anything. We're taking some torpedo hits. Everything is like a slideshow at this point, but I can sort of tell why, because there's so many shells in the air. Oh, okay, their dive bombers are dropping right in front of us. Oh my gosh, please don't hit. So if they get any closer than like right here, the shockwave might actually damage our magazines. Maybe not. Ooh. Oh, we're ripping him to shreds. Oh, yes. He's getting destroyed. Hopefully, they don't get a magazine. I don't know what the next wave is. If the next wave is a battleship, we might be able to take him on easy. Okay. I don't think there's any planes to take off. So we're clean sailing. We might run out of ammo because we've got so many rounds. But look, we've got 20 guns. So each gun has 6 of these. Anybody wants to count that up and tell me like how many rounds they should fire each and then do the math? I'm too lazy to do that. Ooh, the HMS Hood. I have destroyed the Hood with this thing easy. So it was actually too easy to the battle because I started magazining him like instantly. Whoa, what happened? I don't remember this from the last time that happened. Was that him hitting us? I sure hope not. We are both taking some significant damage. Whoa, okay. Don't know what happened there. We just spawned in and our ship was dead. That was a weird ending. I was hoping that I could do more damage. I don't know how I would have started flooding from the inside like that. Maybe it was a glitch. Okay, so that didn't end the way I thought it would. I think that's where I'm gonna end this video off. If you enjoyed, please hit that like button and consider subscribing. Comment down below if you have any ideas for ships I should build. Thanks for watching. Bye.